We have the new color in Distress Spray Stain, Distress Oxide Spray, our Distress Paint, Distress Ink Pad, as well as a re-inker. We also have the new Distress Oxide Ink Pad and its re-inker. And of course, also our Distress Glaze, and of course, our fun enamel pin. How gorgeous is this new color? I went ahead and played with everything. So on the left, we have our Distress Ink, and on the right is the Oxide, so you can see those two compared to each other side by side. Here are some scraps with some spray. We have the Spray Stain on the left and the Oxide on the right. And here is the glaze as well as the paint, so you can see how beautiful those colors are as well. It's such a wonderful deep purple, and it's perfect for Halloween. So I'm going to pair it with Carved Pumpkin and do some ink blending onto some white cardstock. I'm using my scrapbook.com domed foam applicator here and just going to completely color this whole piece of paper with this oxide color. And just look at it. Isn't it beautiful? It's such a perfect purple for Halloween. And I'm so excited it came out just in time for me to do some last minute Halloween cards. I'm using some mint tape to help keep my fingerprints off of my background because I tend to get them everywhere. I'm going to clean up my workstation and we're going to move on to Carved Pumpkin. So I have another sheet of paper, and both of these are slightly larger than A2 because I'm going to run an A2 cover plate die across them. So I wanted to make sure I didn't have to worry about not fitting on my paper. So the both of these are just slightly larger than A2 die. And look at those two colors together. Aren't they perfect? So now I have this diagonal stripe die from Lawn Fawn, and I'm using it to create some striped cuts on my cardstock. I'm going to use some mint tape just to keep those all together so I don't have to remember the order. They're just going to be nicely stuck together over here in the corner while I cut out my orange cardstock piece. And again, using mint tape just to help make sure I don't lose any of those pieces and or get them out of order. So now that those are both done, I've die cut one of the large stitched rectangles as I know that they will match up perfectly. And I'm just using my smart glue here to attach these down. So I am going to do every other color in orange and then purple. So we're creating a fun striped background. I love these dies to be able to create an easy background like this. No guessing about my measurements and if everything is at a correct angle. Makes it really easy. So I started with orange for this first one, and then next will be our villainous potion. And once that is nice and secured, making sure it's not moving, I like to use wet glue for this because it gives me a couple extra seconds of wiggle room to make sure it's in the right spot. I will move back to orange and grab the next piece. And I'm going to continue doing this for both cards. So I have one that has purple triangle corner pieces and the other one has orange triangle corner pieces, and I'm so excited to have these backgrounds. Aren't they beautiful? Again, totally screaming Halloween. So I have one of my pumpkin heads from Tim Holtz Sizzix collection from the Halloween season, and I also have the rainbow die, which is a scrapbook.com die called Rainbow Wishes, and I decided to use both of these as my centerpieces for these cards. I also have Happy Halloween stamped out and cut out with the banner from the Rainbow Wishes die set. And then I thought maybe some vellum would help soften just behind my images here, my pumpkin head and my rainbow, just to create a little bit of contrast so that my die cuts will really pop up against these striped backgrounds. So I have die cut some vellum paper in some kind of oval-ish shapes, and then I'm using my 1/8 of an inch foam adhesive to adhere that down. So I place my vellum onto my background where I want it to go, lightly touched my cut out to it so that we would pick up the vellum, and then I'm going to put wet glue on the back of the vellum where I know it will be covered by my die cut. So that way my vellum is nice and secure to my background, but you don't see any glue. I'm going to pop up this Happy Halloween sentiment strip around my pumpkin head's legs, and that will finish up the main part of this card. I also die cut some black bats from the Ghost Town set too, and I'm going to glue a few of these down. And this pumpkin head die and these bats are all die cut out of various scrapbook.com paper pads. I absolutely love their smooth cardstock packs. It makes it really easy to use the Sizzix colorized dies because you can choose from all different kinds of paper all in one pack. Or maybe you're like me and you have 7 or 8 different color packs to help you create awesome cards. So I'm just using some wet glue to adhere these little bats down just to add a little more fun and detail to this card. And that one is ready for a card base. Next is our rainbow. I thought it would be really fun to create a Halloween rainbow. So of course we want to definitely feature that villainous potion. So that is my largest rainbow stripe, I guess you could say, my top of the rainbow. Next I went into Twisted Citron for a green. And then I had Fossilized Amber for yellow. And of course bringing back that carved pumpkin in the middle for orange. I am using those 1/8-inch strips again to adhere my rainbow down, just like I did my pumpkin head. And this time when I applied that strip, I peeled off both sides of the release paper so that way I could easily bend it around my curved shape of my rainbow. And having both sides of the release paper removed just gives you more flexibility when putting that foam in a curve around the rainbow. And repeating the same process, I have glued down my vellum to my card base using my Smart Craft glue. I have a few more of those bats from the Ghost Town set to Sizzix Thinlets from Tim Holtz, and again just using my craft glue to glue those down in various spots around my rainbow. I absolutely love how this is turning out. I think it's so fun to create rainbows in non-traditional colors, especially when creating for a holiday. So I use my favorite go-to Distress Oxide colors for the season. Once all three of those bats are glued down, it is now ready for a card base as well. So here are our final look at our cards. Here's our Rainbow Wishes Halloween card and our Pumpkin Head Halloween card featuring that brand new Distress Oxide Villainous Potion. I hope you pick up the color yourself and have just as much fun as I did. I'm so excited to see what everyone makes with this new color as it is so vibrant and such a great addition to the purple hues of the Distress Ink color family. Thank you so much for watching and I hope you have a wonderful day.